the social media TV network for your city.
Hey, this is TJ Cates again with another episode of Emerging Artists. We're here with my good friend David Craig.
About it, brother.
Drove in from South Carolina just for this show. I appreciate the effort.
Yes, sir.
So when you spend time in a vehicle, I may have asked you this before. Do you write while you're driving down the road? I mean, in your head, safely?
Yes, sir. It's inspiration hits at all kind of different times. And riding down the road, you know, especially from South Carolina to Nashville, there's so much time just to think. Yeah. You know, and even with the radio on or playing other people's music or whatever, there's still so much time to think. And, you know, it's with me, writing is sitting down with a guitar and playing. And since you can't play guitar and drive.
I can't play guitar at all.
Well, I can't play one and drive. I hadn't tried yet.
Do not try.
I go, you know, I jot down lyrics and stuff, and then sometimes the melody comes before the lyrics, and then you just have to wait till you get somewhere and you play a little bit and see what
kind
of lyrics
come. But you just don't want to lose once you have that in your head.
Yeah, usually it's the idea just to jot down, work off of later. Yeah.
What is your most popular song? Because I've seen you on stage, and you do kind of capture what's going on, and you seem like a really strong storyteller in your songs. They're very detailed from beginning to end. What's your most popular song that people relate to?
Well, as far as the storytelling stuff, man, it's country music has always been telling a story, getting a point across, you know, and something that people can relate to. And so when I write a song, I try to write one that at least one person in every crowd can relate to. And I want to tell a story that's got a meaning. But the one that has actually got a lot of feedback from was, it's called Pocket Knife and a Guardian Angel. And
what's that about?
Well, it's a true story about my life, actually. It starts out talking about when I was a little boy at my first rodeo, and fell in love with it and went and talked to a rodeo clown afterwards and told him that I wanted to be a cowboy, and he handed me a Hawkbill pocket knife and a Guardian Angel. And matter of fact, every cowboy hat that I have that I wear, whenever, you know, I switch out, the angel goes on the back of it.
It's on, you're there.
It's on there right now. Yes, it's right there.
Okay.
He told me that it had kept him safe for so many years, and it was my turn. And for the past 22 years or so, it's kept me safe through riding bulls.
Story.
And, you know, so that it helps when the folks know that it's a true story, and they can relate to, you know, because I'm telling them about me. So,
is that what you're going to play for us today?
Yes, sir.
Well, let's hear it.
All right.
I remember as a boy, still wet behind the ears, at my first rodeo. Oh, it's been so many years. I sat there in awe, I watched the bulls and the broncs. One man that stood above, catching cowboys as they'd fall. When the show was over, well, I went and shook his hand. Man, I want to be like you. This is what he said. If you want to be a cowboy, there's some things that you should know. Two things a cowboy needs, and always hold them close. A pocket knife to help you out each and every jam, and an angel to have you back when the bulls are bearing down. See, if you want a cowboy, ride this dusty trail. You need a pocket knife and a guardian angel. And he reached way down inside the front pocket of his jeans, pulled out a Hawkbill knife, and he handed it to me. Took the angel off his hat, and it on the back of mine. Said, boy, she's kept me safe for years. Now you can have your time. Man, I sure do thank you. Don't think I can repay. He said, oh, now don't you worry. Just remember what I say. If you wanna be a cowboy, there's some things that you should know. Two things a cowboy needs, and always hold them close. A pocket knife to help you out with each and every jam, and an angel to have you back when the bulls are bearing down. So if you want a cowboy, ride this dusty trail. You need a pocket knife and a guardian angel. Well, my boy came to me just the other day. He said, Dad, I want to be like you. Can you show me the way? So I took the angel off of my hat and I handed him my knife. I said, son, these are the words that I've lived by all my life. If you want to be a cowboy, follow Daddy's trail. You need a pocket knife and a guardian angel. You need a pocket knife and a guardian angel.
Talkapolis, the social media TV network for your city.